The Lord said, I will give thoughts of peace and not of affliction. You will call upon me, and I will answer you, and I will lead back your captives from every place. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
The Lord said, I will give thoughts of peace and not of affliction. You will call upon me, and I will answer you, and I will lead back your captives from every place. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
I welcome you to Mass on Monday in the 33rd week in ordinary time, offering this Mass especially for the good estate of San and Win Yo. Of course, in this month of November, we remember all the holy souls, especially those in our funeral books of remembrance and the photos of remembrance at the cemetery. Eternal rest from his clever Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May they rest in peace. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you call your people to turn away from sin. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You teach us wisdom and write your truth in our inmost heart. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You forgive sins through the ministry of reconciliation. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God for ever and ever. Amen.
Stand. is like a tree that is planted beside the flowing waters, that yields its fruit in due season, and whose leaves shall never fade, and all that he does shall prosper.
Lord, is the fruit of victorious,
and the fruit of the tree of life. Not so are the wicked, not so. For they, like wind chaff, shall be driven away by the wind. For the Lord guards the way of the just, but the way of the wicked leads to doom.
Lord, is the fruit of victorious, and the fruit of the tree of life.
Each November, the church in the readings contemplates judgment. And when I look out from here and I'm preaching on it, some faces looking back at me look a bit shocked. And perhaps this is because we live in an age seemingly without consequences, and we're told not to judge. The purpose of the Book of Revelation is to help prepare the church for its definitive encounter with Christ. Grace and peace to you from him who is, and who was, and who is to come. Christ's resurrection cements our belief in his divinity and him being our Lord and Saviour, that he is the bridge between heaven and earth. He is our consolation in times of trial and persecution. Faith, what is faith? Well, in part, it is our growth in the sacred mysteries, which are gradually revealed to us by Christ and in Christ's body, the Church. The Bible has long emphasized an urgency that the time to convert to the gospel is now. But so often we say, mañana, I'll do it tomorrow. It's quite a dangerous attitude because it can mean we can miss opportunities for service that present themselves today. So the Book of Revelation is a call to commitment, to fidelity to the gospel, and especially to our own vocation. And as we'll share in the primary vocation, the call to holiness, the fulfillment of our baptismal promises means that we must keep God's commandments as he has taught us. Our study study of Scripture is a key element to our prayer, and actually it permeates our communal worship. It is the foundation of the sacred liturgy that we are celebrating together. Ephesus. There was a place where the Word of God grew and developed. It was an important Christian city. It was the place where John the Apostle lived, and possibly therefore too Our Lady, whom the Apostle made room for in his home. The church in Ephesus is praised for its endurance and its constancy. The Ephesians are praised for firmly rejecting false apostles, those who distort the gospel for their own agendas. Those agendas are often presented as loving, even though they are often basically untrue. True evangelization is always calling us to repentance, to receive and take to heart the gift of reconciliation that is offered by the death and resurrection of Christ. Son of David, have pity on me, is a call not to let heavenly graces pass us by. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit is the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of your hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his creatures.
Grant, O Lord, we pray that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son you created the human race, so also through him with great goodness you formed it in you. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy be, holy be, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the
holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, he entered willingly into his passion, and he took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world.
By your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks as you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Richard, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
say to you, whatever you ask in prayer, believe that you will receive, and it shall be given to you, says the Lord. Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring the Lord that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So Mass returns to 11 o'clock tomorrow. We'll get to school first. There's rosary at the side altar at our town. The Lord be with you.
Thank you.
May Almighty God bless you.